So this was about the major stock market indices worldwide. Let's talk about some important commodities like gold. In the month of August, I had predicted in one of my videos that because of the conjunction of Rahu and Venus, we can see a sharp up move and then sharp fall in prices of gold and silver. And that we witnessed in the month of August. And now Rahu is entering Taurus sign on 23rd September after just 10 days. So that can also bring a lot of volatility in gold, silver, and stock markets. Regarding gold, we have seen a doji candle on monthly charts after it made a new high of $2,075 per ounce. So now we can see a sluggish moves down move and then bounce back. So this sluggish moves can continue until a full-fledged war starts, and then we can see further up move in gold. So we can see a sluggish move for a month or two before a fresh bull run starts in gold. Regarding silver, same silver has made a sharp rally in the month of July and in the month of May, and now it is cooling down, so it may show a sluggish sideways move for a month or maybe 2 months, and then silver can also start a fresh rally from here. Silver has not yet made new highs. Silver's historical highs has been almost $49.80 in 2011, and from there it is around 40% down still after 9 years. So there is a lot of upside in silver, and we can see a sharp rally in silver in the last quarter. This is already the last quarter. In the last 2 months, November, December, we can see sharp rally in silver. Before that, it may cool down up to $24 or $23. Right now, it closed at $26.69 on Friday. If we talk about crude oil, we saw a good bounce back from the lows of sub-zero levels or near zero levels in the month of April. It went up to $43.76, and then it has given a sharp fall in last 2 weeks. So here also we can see volatile moves, and then with the start of war, there are possibilities of some sharp up moves in crude oil prices also. But this can be a very volatile commodity, so we need to be very careful while trading in crude oil. Regarding copper, in the base metals, copper is considered the king of base metals, and copper has given a very good rally in the past few months since April. So we can see a continuation in this upward move in copper. However, we can see volatile moves here also on daily prices. But month on month, we can see up move in copper. It can surpass the highs of 2018, and it can touch the historical highs of $4.64 of 2011 in the next year. May not be this year, but copper, we can be bullish on copper for several months. So those who do intraday trading, they should be careful. These are my opinion for a long-term view, long-term investment, not for intraday trading, not for trades for 2-3 days. So for intraday trading or trades for 2-3 days, a few days, you need to be careful. You need to consult professionally, and then we can give you advice, opinion regarding that. Regarding natural gas, in our last few videos we had told that we can see a new up move in natural gas, and we saw that up move in the month of July and August, and we had also told that it would cool down before starting another up move. So in September we have seen that retracement in price of natural gas. So it can retrace a little more, and then it can again start a fresh up move. And once it goes about $2.7 again, then we can see a very sharp up move in natural gas prices again. So these are my views on some important commodities. Let's discuss about currencies. This is dollar index. Dollar index has sustained a very critical level of 91. It made a low of 91.72 last week. This 91 was a sharp, was a critical level. If it had breached and sustained below 91, then we could have seen a sharp further fall, but it has sustained that level. And we still need to see whether it is still able to sustain over 91 level or not. Regarding euro versus dollar, here also it has not been able to cross the high of 1.21. 1.21 is a crucial level in euro versus dollar. Once it goes above 1.21 and continues to stay above that, then we can see a further sharp rally in euro. Let's talk about pound. Pound versus dollar. Here it has briefly closed above the important level of 1.32, but did not sustain above that, and it has again started falling. So it can again trade in a small range of 1.34 and 1.20. So these are my views on the basis of technical analysis on various stock market indices, commodities and currencies. Friends, you can share your questions, you can share your views through comments with us. Please subscribe my YouTube channel if you like this kind of videos, and let me know your feedback. Also share our videos with your friends, with your contacts, and thanks for watching till the end. Take care. Bye bye.